here.
Okay, I need everybody to stop.
Woo!
Crazy.
All right, so I would like to welcome you guys to the Cypress Slough. What do you guys think so far?
It's great.
Awesome.
Cold, but amazing, right?
It's amazing. It's
all right, amazing. So this is your afternoon. We are going to let you guys explore. There is a lot of amazing wildlife right here all around us. And we have given you guys the tools. Hunter, can I borrow your backpack real quick?
Sure.
Let me see the...
To really get in and explore this place.
I'll take the net out.
So first, Hunter has his dip net. This is an excellent tool for finding all kinds of different fish. We have crustaceans, all kinds of cool stuff here. So inside of your backpacks, you have a guide to the things that you're going to find here in the slough. On the first page, it's got a bunch of different fish that you guys will find over here, all kinds of different aquatic life. So that's a good tool for you. You also have another guide to the fish. You have... So you guys, take your packs, go out and explore, and I'll call you back in probably like a half hour, and we're going to go look and discuss all the awesome things we found.
I don't see any here.
So that's probably a female flagfish, okay. Is what that is.
And now I'm stuck. The boys have found a shrimp.
My foot is like completely stuck. There we go.
What kind of fish is this one?
Hey, should we put water in it?
That.
Like a crayfish.
Yeah, there's a couple of those.
Okay, snail. We found a glass shrimp, but I'm having trouble finding it.
Why don't you just, could you just tell me what it looks like?
It's a very small shrimp, and it's called a glass shrimp because you can see through it. You can see like its brain and everything.
Oh, the fish just ate it.
The fish ate it?
Yeah.
We lost it.
Yep, the fish ate it.
Is it Albert? Really? Look at that crow.
Oh, wow.
I don't think he's going to fit. Let me see. That's the problem.
What are you?
Oh. And he's going to pinch me. But check him out. That's a big one.
Crayfish.
Who
is
that?
Who found that?
Wow, you guys have quite the collection.
Parker
that's awesome.
Get it, and he dropped it.
Man, I can't. It was slippery.
What was it?
Slippery.
Wow, very cool.
What?
The stuff. I'm looking for that big crayfish.
I'm wave going towards Julia.
So I'd like to congratulate you guys right now for your very first slough slog. You are now Glades men and Glades women. So I'd like you guys to give yourselves a round of applause. Very good job. And you guys were wonderful explorers today. You found some amazing stuff. So I would like to go around the circle first off and have you guys show at least one of the things that you found today to the group. So would you guys like to go first?
Yes.
All right.
And then we got a bunch of little glass shrimp.
Yeah, this group got quite a few glass shrimp, which are really amazing to see. If we put the glass shrimp in that magnifying glass, you'd be able to see right through their body. One day we found a mother with eggs inside of her belly. We could see all of her eggs. Very amazing. All right, you guys did an amazing job.
Snails,
they also got some ram's horn snails, some live ones,
and some fishies,
and a water beetle. Are we up to Jake and Chase's group?
Those are all eggs, right?
Yeah. As far as I can tell, it looks like those are eggs. As you guys can tell, we are in the middle of the dry season and everything is drying down. So I want you to take a look at those trees. What kind of trees are those again, guys?
Have you put them in a lot of new
these
trees?
Right here, these are bald cypress trees. These trees are pretty much completely covered with lichen. So, and then also, if you take a look, do you guys have any idea what these plants are that are covering these trees? Jake?
Airplant,
excellent. Also called bromeliads. So they are covering these trees. Do you guys have any idea where they might be getting their nutrients from? Chase, Tina?
Do they get their nutrients from the air when it's on the tree?
Excellent. They're not taking any nutrients from the tree. They're just taking the nutrients from the air, which is pretty cool. Also, sometimes bugs will fall inside of the air plants and they will start to decay, and that's another way that the air plants will get their nutrients, is from those dead and decaying insects. But most of it just comes right from the air. All they use the trees for is really support. Yeah, there's quite a few of them that are flowering right now. Those flowers, when they turn to seed, the seeds are these really wispy things that will fly up into the air and they'll just get stuck right underneath a little piece of the bark on the cypress tree. And that's how they start to grow. They'll just start growing right there from that very spot. So I want you guys, before we go, I want you to take a good look around you. What do you guys think? This is a pretty amazing place, isn't it?
Yeah.
You guys are probably ready to go. So I'm going to ask you guys to dump out your aquariums and return what you found back to the marsh.
Oh!
Isn't that awesome?
That is so awesome.
That was fun, I guess.
That was fun.
You guess? I'm going to say, what's not fun about it?
I almost did. Almost.
I almost fell today, too.
Over a log again.
There was just, wasn't there a log right there?
Yeah, he went right on it, and he almost fell, and then he went up again, and his foot was stuck.
Yeah.
Hey, Honor.
You fell in?
Look at your right heel.
My what?
Your right heel.
What do I got on it?
Just some seaweed. Or whatever.
I need to empty my shoes. Shut up.